I looked around. The whole town was painted red. Skulls, bodies, and all manner of innards strewn about. It was all my doing. A rampage, total loss of control. My right arm was still fresh. Warm, eviscerated entrails. I had little room for denial. The clock on my humanity is winding down. I stood in the ruins with the dank stench of death, reflecting upon the gravity of my sins.
It seems all the residents have been consigned to oblivion.
This sacrifice.
Then an image of my mother flashed into my mind. Why now? This was not usual. There must be some reason that I would remember her at this moment. Only later would I realize that it was all fated to happen. From the moment I set foot in that town, I knew that it was the place my mother once lived. For it perfectly matched a story I heard when I was very young. My mother was driven out over some insignificant happenings.
A fine spree of death indeed.
Magusar spoke with dead calm.
Only your victims were not alive in the first place.
5 days until the end of the world.
The journal begins to touch somehow upon the author's mother. Why would she suddenly come up now? Read on to discover the most peculiar answer.
When we came upon my mother's town, its inhabitants had perished long before. A story my mother told me long ago explained this. The tale matched what she had said. The townspeople were projections. I had massacred apparitions. Eerie phantoms, which were the work of one man. The man loved his fair town. Loved it too much, one might say. When disease struck the town, the man refused to believe it. His desires led him to stray from the path of good. With ghastly newfound powers, he restored the good old days. We came for him, and started with the destruction of his phantom puppets. We knew that slaughtering his dolls would tease him out.
It seems we've lured out the monster, just as we planned.
Unstoppable.
These are mere scratches. These are mere scratches. These are mere scratches.
Deeply wounded, the Cerberus fled. Magusar mentioned it as we pursued the beast.
I am your partner. Only.
Magusar said that he feared me. Alarmed at the violence I exhibited toward these ghosts. Convinced that I would have done the same to real people.
Remember, I must take your life before my premonitions come to pass.
Magusar was preparing for the moment of truth. And who could blame him? I could feel what was happening to my body. My humanity was approaching its frail end. We pursued the monster, but it was a trap. We soon faced a woman who claimed to be Magusar's former partner. 5 days until the end of the world.
The author of the journal is now almost a monster. And the relationship with Magusar is transforming. According to the sorcerer's recollection,
it was Illisibra. She was beaming. But I still could not get over her striking likeness to Sortiara.
I knew something was stirring in these parts.
For Illisibra, this was reason enough to follow Magusar. I was shocked to hear what she proceeded to tell us. Illisibra said that she once lived in this town. The description made my heart race. It perfectly matched what my own mother had once told me. It occurred to me that I had never been able to remember my mother's face. It was imperative that I reconsider just who this Illisibra might be. Until then, she was only the woman who claimed to be Magusar's former partner. But that seemed less likely. She is something else.
She keeps saying that we used to be partners.
I hope you don't mind if I join you.
Stay put.
This town is a rather special place for me.
He's a near scratch.
What? This town is once my home. To stay here.
Those wounds of yours need to be treated. These are mere scratches. Those wounds of yours need to be treated. These are mere scratches. Stay focused.
Only to factories.
Before the epidemic wiped out the town, Illisibra had lived here. But the townsfolk feared her magic and banished her. Not long after Illisibra left, the town was struck by the epidemic. This is no mere coincidence. Her story is a perfect match to the one I heard from my mother in my youth. Still, I could not recall my mother's face. The vagueness of my memory was unnerving. A dreadful thought crossed my mind. I heard a monster howl in the distance. Illisibra grinned and walked away. Could this witch be my mother? I knew I had to ask, but she was gone before I had the chance. 5 days until the end of the world.
Illisibra, who strongly resembles Sultiara, spoke of the same things as his mother. Could it be that Illisibra is the sorcerer's mother? His writing clearly demonstrates his confusion.
We once again faced the Cerberus. Magusar spoke. He told me that the monster resented me. Yes, he most certainly does. For I had dissipated his great cast of characters, his entire town of phantom inhabitants. Magusar said something odd.
I wish to absorb the hatred harbored by this Cerberus.
But what use did Magusar have for hatred?
to ease the pain. Make it possible to take your life.
The Cerberus stewed in anger at me. By absorbing the dog in sacrifice, Magusar could inherit that seething ire. Magusar was thinking ahead, preparing his emotions. Perhaps the memory of our next victim will contain a hint about the chalice. I return to the fray on a sliver of hope.
If we don't find the chalice, I shall have to kill you. The beast must be put to death. Our survival depends on it.
That thing! That damn thing!
He's a mere stranger.
I'll let you decide what to do with me.
Our enemy is strong. We must be on our guard.
I'll let you decide what to do with me. Don't do anything stupid, right? That thing. Damn me.
is a mere spread.
I'll let you decide.
These are mere scratches. We must be on our way. These are mere scratches. Our enemy is strong. We must be on our guard. These are mere scratches. It's no use. I cannot move. These are mere scratches. Stay focused. barrier structures. These are mere scratches. Enemy strong. We must be on our guard. Our enemy is strong. We must be on our guard. Those wounds of yours need to be treated. These are mere scratches.
I don't want to die!
But without sacrificing, I could gain no memories. And therefore no leads on the sacred chalice. And as for me, I was just another step closer. A step closer towards destroying the world.
You are the only one that I am truly honest with. But even so, at first, I was determined to not hesitate to kill you.
I knew what this meant. How painful it must have been for Magusar to admit these feelings. Why proclaim that you won't hesitate? Unless you are afraid that you will. Emotions are not something easily set aside. He must, after all, take a life with his own hands. The life of a friend who has given him more time than his own family. I am sure only guilt awaits one at the end of that route. I was deeply tormented by what I had done to Sortiara. I had walked over her corpse, and now was haunted by her visage. The thought of death made me think of separation. Could I handle this? Could Magusar? Perhaps our friendship could be forgotten, but our time spent together could not. By now, we accommodated one another effortlessly. We were, after all, human, despite the great prices paid. 5 days until the end of the world.
You've read a good way through. Perhaps one day I can divulge the truth to you. The truth contained in this journal.